Let's talk a little bit about imaginary numbers and what that is. So let's start with saying that we have an equation x over 2 equals 9. It's pretty basic. X is plus minus square root of 9, which is plus minus 3. Let's draw that up on the number line. Minus 3. X can either be that or there. Meaning something times itself yields a positive number. But what if we were to have a different variable z, which is to the power of 2 equals minus 9. Now we run into some problems, because as we see on the number line and the rules for this equation, we cannot get a negative number from the number times itself. We need to figure out something else. Let's see, 7 equals plus minus the square root of minus 9. We want to get rid of this like square root of minus 1. We don't like that, so we say plus minus square root of 9 times the square root of minus 1. Minus 3 times I, the letter I. I, right down here, is just the square root of minus 1. This right here does not exist on the real number line. One value times itself and then get a negative number. So we need to create a whole new number line just for this property right here. Here we write 3i, 2i, just make sure that, so, I, minus I, minus 2i, minus 3i. Essentially what we did was just take the real number line and just multiply I by every value. So this is the imaginary number line, and this is the real number line. We can do some interesting stuff with this. So this value here is 3 and 3. Let's say we get a question on an exam. We want to solve this equation. X over 2 minus 4 x plus 8 equals 0. So we just solve for x. Pretty straightforward. X equals minus 4 divided by 2 plus minus 4 divided by 2 to the power 2 minus 8. Just so you can also use the quadratic formula. Let's solve for this. So x equals 2, this is 2, plus minus the square root of 4 minus 8 equals 2 plus minus the square root of minus 4, which is 2 plus minus 2i. X1 is 2 plus minus 2i. Plus plus, then x2 is minus. Let's draw it up on this little number, a little bit more complex number line. So we take 2 plus 2i. 2 plus 2i. 2 minus 2i. 2 minus 2i. So we can write that as 2 plus 2i. 2 minus 2i. So if you are ever doing a calculation and you end up with the square root of a negative number, you can say that there is no solution on the real number line. You have to move to more complex